He's gonna go for the rune. He's actually slowed up, and the monkey
king. That is not a rune he wanted. All right, he's gonna have to juke this for 4 seconds. He looks like he might have just made his way out. Crystal is gonna come into trees. Here comes the orb, jump away, but it's not far enough. Monkey King, that is not a traditional melee hero right there.
The top general. Now he's gonna get gone on, throwing out the blast, but unless he can get himself denied, and he does.
Oh! Sure, he gets a little spooked. Lays down a clap, mid one, in mid, almost. Yeah, they're gonna go for the dive here, a little bit more tick, but he's got the Fairy Fire and a healing salve, so he'll be okay here. Draws a lot of damage on Snake. Oh, he's actually dead from that one. The double damage is surely gonna help out his offlane, which has been a struggle for him so far. Mid lane, mid one, in some big trouble, gonna be charged up, unable to get the
not
leap out.
Able to dodge that.
Centaur stun, kills the other Centaur, that's not a bad play, but mid one is still gonna have too much damage heading his way. He ends up going down. Yamcha trying to get the roll in on Roger, actually misses entirely.
Oh, he's
now he's going to get charged up. But, oh, what a kick just in time. The charge on Fada is coming through. Now, Fada's got two supports coming in, so he's thinking he's okay with this. But, oh, dodge the phase shift. Does manage to get out. Oh, just barely at the end of that boundless strike. Gets Fada, and it's a really so much damage. So the smoke will be used mid. Fada does manage to dodge some of that, gets the silence out on Dendi, but he's not going to be able to jump to his orb. Crystallize gets the boundless strike, stopping him from jumping away.
This is going to be way too late.
Yeah.
Free tower here as Fada must absolutely hate Crystallize.
Maybe they can actually get a team fight out of it though. Crystallize is going to start popping his ultimate though. As the TP completes from the Bane, he is just going to get gobbled up almost immediately. What a three-man stun though from Yapzor. That kind of buys some time for the rest of the Seeker to be able to get out of there, because that
they
was a terrible
retreat.
Fight.
He lays down the ward, so he gets vision of the charge. Might be able to catch Yapzor, and he does.
It's Tsuneko, but the charge is already hit onto Yapzor. So he turns, gets another two-man kick, but here comes
Fada. Here's the coil
with the silence on top. Oh no, everything has gone disastrously now for Na'Vi. They lose three all of a sudden. And Fada was thinking about it, but doesn't throw down that coil.
Yeah, and they're placing sentries everywhere, but haven't found Na'Vi's wards quite yet.
And here comes the full five-man from Na'Vi. They're going to run at this one. They're going to go for the Earth Spirit first. Should be a pretty easy kill, though. They're turning around to Krep.
I don't think it is.
To help them out a little bit. He gets a roll deeper away, and the news coming in for the Queen of Pain. So they manage to get that one. But a trade-off potentially. Monkey King dropping so low, he needs a little bit more damage. They manage to catch General in the back line, but Puppy can't get away from this one as he's dusted up. Moonlight Shadow, not going to be able to save him. Fada still trying to get those extra kills. He actually did manage to get the Pugna there.
Yeah.
Those kind of instances.
The issue with that, though, is that they are getting behind in levels as Puppy. Oh, the charge through as well.
Charge knocking back the Bane and trying to go for those extra kills, but Midwan is far enough away. His team won't be able to pursue.
If this does happen, Na'Vi actually does want to come into the fight while Dendi's making those kinds of plays, because they think that they can win the 4v5 with the Pugna. As that bottom Fada going to get gone on again, Crystallize. Once again, the Bane of his existence.
It looks like he tried to lock him down with the ultimate there.
Oh, he got
force staff. Staff usage there. Ace managed to stop the TP by breaking the coil.
They've got too many mobile heroes. It's too hard to lock him down.
Orchid being used on the Bane.
Oh,
the kick! The kick silence onto three. Midwan's going to stand and fight here. He's trying to right click down Tsuneko. He's the first one down. Here comes Fada looking for an extra silence onto the Queen of Pain. But Roger's fighting Midwan pretty well. Midwan has to actually leave himself away from the Enchantress to be able to get away from
Dendi.
This one. Underneath the tier one tower. Ace is going to try and finish him off. Looks like Dendi was able to make the blink away though. Very key hero. It's
but
a big
secret?
Power spike for them, right?
Yes. If you're not willing to fight around that, then you pretty much can't fight.
Puppy first. Tries to sleep himself, does dodge a decent amount of damage now. They actually get the charge in from Tsuneko trying to finish off the Bane, but he's not getting a charge. Now he's going to be Fiend's gripped up, loses his life. Now they're going to be able to get Puppy. 1-for-2 exchange so far, but a lot has already been blown by Na'Vi, which is why Crystallize has his own secret from pursuing them.
They got to get out.
He stays in his ultimate as long as he can, but they're going to jump to the other side with Vada, get some more damage on a Crystallize. This is the hero that they want to be able to clean up at the end of all this, because they know the rest of Na'Vi is not in a situation to be able to fight. To Crystallize, copy the old scepter delayed up once again. See if they can get the extra nuke damage. Midwan goes for it, but now in a bit of a trap. Pops the man to get out. Could clash in a secret.
Yeah, their lanes are shoved in. This is one of the better opportunities.
Here comes
that
the charge onto Vada, but he has phase shift. So this initiation is already a little bit off kilter. They're going to turn, get the Yule Scepter onto him, throw out the arrow, and Tsuneko completely controlled up.
Oh,
the rest
kick.
Of Na'Vi aren't going to be able to protect him a little bit. Oh no, the drain's just not enough to protect against that damage. Now they've actually caught him. Oh no, what happened? Roger gets a little bit too close to Puppy. If he gets that level 25 attack speed increase, which I think has been kind of the norm.
Nah, dude, multi-shot. Right?
No, you like the multi-shot more?
Tsuneko, he's going in for this.
Maybe
Yapzor actually gets caught by this.
They're going to be able to go for the Earth Spirit first, but already Navi stopping up that Fiend's Grip. Puppy's going to be able to control the Monkey King in the back line. That's going to be really helpful, slowing down the damage of Navi. As you can see, Midwan is still in full form. He's going to be able to bring down Roger here in a little bit, but actually has to give up on that kill. The heal, Fido will actually clean it up. Crystallize throws out his ultimate. That his impact is pretty much null now. He's stuck inside his own ultimate, trying to zone out the rest of Secret, giving himself some opportunity to Crepify from General. Will buy him a little bit of time to start backing himself up, but the rest of the team turns and gets Dendi instead. Now the pursuit is Ace continuing to slow down. Crystallize is not letting him be able to leap away. General's up next, may have popped his BKB, dodging the slow, but it seems like both Ace and Fodder are going to be able to keep up with him. A kick forward by Yapzor. It's just a little bit of extra helping hand that allow them to get the full five-man wipe on Na'Vi. Shadow, the poor man's smoke for Secret almost catches Dendi.
Oh, it's gonna catch Roger instead.
It looks like it is gonna catch the Enchantress, maybe even more with Coil going out. Sineko tries to buy Roger time, unable to do so though. Coil still holding General in place. Crystallize thinking about throwing out that ultimate, trying to protect Sineko. Sineko suicides into the Bane, trying to get whatever stuns he can before he dies.
Oh, they're just force-stacking around this fight.
Secret are just playing around this ultimate entirely. Puppy is gonna commit for it, gets the Fiend's Grip. He's giving up his life to make sure that they get this kill, but the Shrine? Somebody Shrine for him! They're trying to heal him up with General, but they don't quite get the Shrine. Dendi was stunned up for too long. Crystallize dies as well, and this is going to be Secret now forcing that buyback of Yule Scepter. He's got a buyback now because he's needed to be able to protect Dendi, already stunned and silenced up. Fada blows him up!
Look at that damage.
The Dagon comes in. Again, the Shrine. Too little, too late. Crystallize turns, managed to get the two-man stun, but four heroes. Midwan barely gets himself away. Actually, their turn. Crystallize is getting some free hits off of this when he now has the life steal. He can actually stand against this, but they already calling it. There was that one game where they were abandoning Ace. In some trouble here. General locked him in with a Cogs, but he's completely out of damage, so he's entirely reliant on battery assault, and he's just not getting the ticks he needs to be able to get the kills. Sineko tries to pick him up, and he gets it. Just barely. He goes for the TP out.
Oh,
wisely, and he does make it out. Nicely played. Okay, so we want to check out the Nightmare that's currently setting up the engagement, the Razor. Trying to steal some damage away from Crystallize, and they'll have just enough.
As a result of all these swaps, do you really even want these lanes anymore?
Uh-oh. Ace? He may have stolen the damage from Sineko, but General will stand and fight with the Battery Assault and the limited amount of right-click damage that he does. Ace turns.
Ace,
what is
he
doing?
Turn.
Oh, no. He's trying to turn. Now the Creep Wave is here to be able to tank up some of their Battery Assault, but the Maledict is gonna tick him down.
Fueling their TPs. I'm going to count that after.
Midwan. Crystallize is actually going to join his allies in killing Midwan, probably because the Dragonite popping his ultimate and threatening that tower was such a big commitment.
Oh, he's dead.
He is dead. It's not even close. They pop the Shrine. He's good. Fada keeps moving forward. They pop the Healing Salva. Now a turn from Crystallize with the help of Roger.
They want to go for this.
Down. Here comes Yapzor, though. He's going to toss him into Crystallize. Underneath
the
tower range as well for the sleep. Holding him in while they finish off Roger. With right clicks, they'll get him. Now Crystallize left alone.
Oh,
he knows he's
dead.
He's going to go for the kill on Vada, but can't get enough damage out in time. Midwan acts like he's backing out. Pops Shadowblade.
Oh, if he catches.
Right back in.
He wants
to be able to
here.
Grab Sineko. Right next to the tier 2 tower. The plasma field easily blowing him up. Now, General came in pretty quick. Managed to lock Midwan in.
Here comes the relocate.
Close. They're going to be able to get not just one kill, potentially more. With the relocate in, they're going to be able to get the Razor as well. They're turning around here. Yapzor only steals a rocket. He can't do much with that, so he's going to try and make it a TP out. He does make it.
Very important rotation, though. That's going to firmly cement his lead. Number one in net worth. Has that Mask of Madness now.
No.
Roshan is an open opportunity for them, too.
It's like added insult to injuries. That cast just keeps bouncing back the poor puppy off of the neutrals. But he does have some allies in. Fada. Fada about me. Oh, that is a long grab. But Fada still has the blink, so he's good.
And Ace actually.
He's
going
to be the
here.
One kind of caught here. General tries to go for the dive. No Shrine activatable. Crystallize pulls him back, too. Secret coming in one by one here. Midwan's here now, and he's going to go for the quick kill onto Roger.
But really good fight so far from Na'Vi.
I mean, I can understand why Na'Vi group up so much. It seems to work out for them so oftentimes, right? That bottom fight where Secret tries something, met by so many heroes of Na'Vi. They manage to get another engagement, though.
The
quickly
Brood would be a huge
one
kill.
And two, Broodmother goes down. That's the biggie. I mean, Secret's like...
Oh,
I think
the
they,
long grip! if that leads to a kill...
Yapzor's here for the pickup. Crystallize and General are going to try and fight this one. Phantasm goes out, managed to get the pullback on Ace with the Paralyzing Cast, bouncing over to the Bane as well. It's going to stay on the Crystallize, even getting Yapzor in the back line. Two easy kills for Na'Vi.
And the CK, despite all that happening, and they don't really care too much because they are getting towers in general.
Oh no, get booped right in front of a Haste Rune, picked up by Midwan. Eats his way through the cogs, gonna try and just run away. General's gonna be the easy kill for Secret. Paralyzed Cass bouncing back over to Sineko.
And Dendi making his way forward.
Okay,
but
now it's a 3v5. Navi, I don't know how they possibly win this one. It's gonna be Roger ends up going down from it.
They wanna keep chasing for this.
Yeah, Fata's
caught crystallized in the back.
TP out, yeah, Zor gets the cask! 17-9, we'll turn to 18.
Yeah.
Back into that high ground area. Navi are still playing in their offlane jungle this whole entire time. The ward is going to be taken away. Yaptor actually tries for the initiation here, throwing him into mid one. Fast kill on the Witch Doctor. Phantasm popped up by Crystallize.
Navi don't
feel like they can take this engagement, even though they've committed the Phantasm. They're trying to back themselves up. Roger's going to be caught here. Burst damage galore for Secret.
Yeah, and CK, his illusions, just gonna run away. They should know that these are all fakes.
Yeah, they see Phantasm out, and they're like, okay, we picked off two. Now we might have caught the real Chaos Knight here. Fiend's gripped up. No save from anybody, so that's gonna be three down. Oh. Plus Phantasm stolen for Yapzor, so
the key is, does he have the luck?
Get that extra illusion.
Oh, there's four of them.
Yeah, it's only level two. I thought it was level three.
No. There's a bunch of Rubik's hitting him. It's like insult to injury. He does get the extra one.
Yeah. And there goes the mid lane of Rax. Navi can't really do much about this. They're still going to try and initiate, though, but they don't have the Phantasm. That's a big damage dealer. Dendi's going to go for Ace here, losing some of his damage, but Ace is still going to drop. It looks like Dendi was able to overwhelm him. And the back lines are trying to go for the Wisp, but it's not enough to get the first step
away. Mid one.
He goes for the BKB teleport out, but his BKB doesn't last long enough. They get the stun down, and Navi, they do successfully win this. Fata trying to go for those supports in the back line, but they're all healed up.
He wants to put a stamp on this game. Invis'd up, does see Dendi.
Dendi.
Here's the stun.
He's caught. He's gonna end up dropping here now. He has that extra life, so it's about whether or not Navi are able to fight around that one. The paralyzing pass does buy a little bit of time, but the BKB goes off from Dendi, just trying to make it back. The extra web goes down. Run, Dendi, run! Gets back to base. General intercept.
Cogs.
Does manage to get the cogs in, but could it be Fiend's Grip immediately? Now, they did have the Chaos Knight coming in. Looks like in the secret shop area, Dendi's gonna go straight for Ace, trying to get that kill outside the web. Does manage to get it.
Here comes Crystallize.
He killed the support, now comes back in and gets an extra one as well. Crystallize, though, out of his illusion. The AoE damage from both Fata and the cleave out from mid one is too much for them to handle. They lose all their damage.
But Dendi is really far forward. Mid one invis.
Okay,
you
see mid one, right?
Anymore.
That was their sentry.
The BKB
barely goes off in time. They just didn't have an instant stun. Mid one's fast enough. They're going to try and go for the relocate out. They're out. Whoo!
Half a second too late.
Let's see if they can actually keep the Wisp alive. For the instant of mid one, it seems unlikely. But they're gonna try for it. Sineko's still kinda hanging around. He's gonna go for the paralyzing cast. They're gonna turn and fight with the Phantasm out. They're gonna go for this one. They can try and go for the Razor first. He's already dead. Fata controlled up. Does man and face
it. Dendi is doing so much damage.
He's just killing all these heroes. The Maldict on mid one. He doesn't have a BKB. He's gonna drop as well. No, he did it. They win this fight. Take down three.
Overstaying their welcome completely. And now they've gotta do something with this. General goes down. Fata.
Take that, Fata, but oh, no phase shift.
You need to kill for this?
No phase shift. That is not a trait they want to be able
to do. This would be a huge kill.
Blink up. 2 seconds, but it's not going to be up in time. He ends up going down. A 1-for-4 trade now.
People die really easily in Dota. And again, Clockwork Blade Mail gets progressively stronger.
Yeah. And BKBs always feel weaker when you don't have like really fast damage.
Yeah, but right? Mid one, invis'd up. He wants to look for something.
Oh, they're going to be able to catch General and throw him into Sineko here. What a great setup. But the paralyzing cast is going to slow things down, but mid one with a BKB and the splash is going to be able to take one kill. They're healing up General a lot, but it's going to cost Roger his life, and it looks like General's still going to die. Oh no, Navi just is beginning to get some glimmers of hope.
Secret. They're going to spot this. They're going to find the Witch Doctor.
Thrown up into the high ground. There's the Blink Dagger from General going straight for Yapzor here, trying to control him, and he does not have a Force Staff to be able to get himself out. But inside the Roshan pit, they're trying to stop
so
the Roshan.
Oh, Dendi's going all in for it right now.
Onto both of them. Dendi full on committed for the Roshan. The BKB being used for this as well, just to be able to get that extra life and cheese. They'll get it, but can they win the fight afterwards? With no BKB on Crystallize and most of their supports gone, it seems hard for Navi to turn on this one at all. They're going to be controlled off on Crystallize. Dendi trying to kill the sentries just to be able to stay out of vision here as he's trying to escape with the Aegis intact, but not going to be able to do it. He loses that extra life. Crystallizes down as well. They may have won the Roshan fight, but oh, Dendy can't even make it out.
Five
they
for zero.
They get the Roshan, but they lose the fight.
Might not be long for this world.
Do you even fight on this first lane of Racks? You go.
Nah, they're going for it.
All right, Maledict on mid one. He does not have a BKB, so if they could focus him down, potentially sleep actually buys them a little bit of time. That crucial second is so big. Now Fauna comes in with a big AoE. They turn against the three, and they're splashing through every single one of them. Seneca will call it GG.